those shiatsu chair massagers? I have a story about one. So Thanksgiving Thursday, I'm making dinner. It's just no for blacks and I, so I don't do a huge spread. I just did turkey, mashed potatoes, green beans, and cranberry. Your very basic, you know, trimmed down Thanksgiving meal. If you've watched some of my earlier videos, you know that I have suffered from back problems. Well, for some reason over the last couple of weeks, I've had this one little spot on my back that would every once in a while go into spasm and get really painful when it does that. Off and on, sporadic. Well, on Thanksgiving, while I think it was when I was trying to remove the big pot of the potatoes that I've been boiling for mashed potatoes and bring it over to the sink to drain them, I must have moved wrong or done something not quite right and sent that little area into spasm again. Most unpleasant. Hurt quite a bit. And so I mentioned it to Noferblatz because I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to get, I had a 21-pound turkey. I know, it's huge for two people. I like my turkey leftovers. Anyway, I was concerned that getting the 21-pound bird out of the pan over onto the platter was going to be a little dicey for me to do with my back going, you know. So I'd mentioned it to him. Thankfully, I got it done okay, no problems. But he said, why don't you use the chair massager? We have this shiatsu chair massager. It's this thing that you sit in your chair and then you lean back on it and it has the little things that go up and down your back, okay? I'm thinking, well, yeah, it hurt a lot. So sure, why not? So he brought it out to the living room. We typically eat dinner in our recliners because it's just the two of us, you know? So we just sit in the recliners, watch TV and eat dinner. So I had it in my recliner, which unfortunately means, of course, you're leaning back a little bit. And that probably puts a little bit more weight on whatever you're leaning back on, okay? So I went to lean back on this massager and get it started. Agony. Oh my God, it hurt as it started to work its way up my back. Yeah, it has heat on it too, so I had the heat going. And after a while, it didn't hurt so much. So I'm like, okay, good. I'm just going to let it do its thing. These massagers have timers. And I think they probably have those timers for a reason, but I ignored it. When it cut itself off at the end of its cycle, I started it back up. Let it go some more. When it cut itself off, I let it, you know, started it back up. I did that for, I guess it was probably a little over an hour. Maybe even, it may have been pushing 2 hours. We usually, No, we didn't finish watching the movie when I first got up. So it was probably about maybe a little over an hour then. When I first stood up after having this going up and down my back for that long, I thought, oh, it's really tender back there. I'm thinking, if I mentioned Noferblatz, it's like it's almost bruised. And he laughed off, nah, it's just your muscles are sore, that's all. Okay. But I didn't use it anymore the rest of the night. That night, go to bed, thinking everything's okay. In the middle of the night, sound asleep, go to roll over in bed and bolt upright in pain when I went to move. My back, the entire back, not just the little area that was spasming before, my entire back was in pain. Like, what? The mere pressure of being on my bed was horrendously painful. How weird. So I ended up getting up in the wee hours of the morning, early that morning, getting up, going and getting the newspaper, go in to sit down in my recliner to read my paper, and as soon as my back touched the chair, I wasn't expecting it, you know, because I was still kind of half asleep. I literally yelped out loud in pain. Now, I should back up. Noferblatz likes to say that I don't understand pain. Because what he calls pain, I'll say is uncomfortable. I have a medical condition that was really bad for many, many years, and it caused me a whole lot of pain. I mean, we're talking literally 2 weeks of straight pain every month. So 2 weeks in pain, 2 weeks not in pain, 2 weeks in pain, 2 weeks not in pain, and at times really intense pain. That raised my pain tolerance a lot. I mean, having to deal with that, it's not like I could sit there and take pain meds all the time because I had to work, I had to function, so I had to just learn to deal with it. And so most moderate pain to me is just background noise. You know, I hardly even notice it. It's only when pain reaches a really high level that I'm like, you know, this was pain. This was serious pain. Once I was finally settled and leaned back, then the pain stopped. It was just that initial coming in contact, anything coming in contact with my back was agonizing. I mean, my entire back. So when Overblatz got up, I told him about it. And I was like, it's like my entire back is bruised. And he's still laughing it off. And I finally had to say, look, you know how I am about pain. This is pain, okay? It was horrible. We have this ointment, mineral ice. And so I had him, with the most delicate touch, which was still painful, had him put that on my back. But here it is, let's see, that was Friday, Saturday, Sunday, this is Monday that I'm filming this. And there are still tender places. If I were to put any serious pressure on my back, it's still tender. I mean, the worst day was Friday. Friday was just horrible, which was the day after I'd done this. You know, I did it Thursday night. So if you ever use a shiatsu chair massager, do not ignore the programming time limit. I think it's there for a reason. Do not let it keep going for over an hour. You will regret it, I promise you. That's all. That was just a little extra video that I figured I'd share with you. Come back and see me.
See ya.